Linux Mint 19 brings refinements and many new features to make already good Linux Mint experience even better. Let's review it. Linux Mint has always been my favorite distribution. It's my first recommendation to new users. If you want to become a Linux user, you can't go wrong with Linux Mint. The release of Linux Mint 19 forces me to recommend Linux Mint even more. What about you? Would you recommend Linux Mint to new users or something else? Please comment below. And let's have a look at 10 reasons why I recommend Linux Mint 19. Number 1. Linux Mint is well known for its user-friendliness and stability. Linux Mint 19 is not different on that side. I have tested it for a week and I have no complaints. Actually, I would say this stability makes reviewing Linux Mint really boring. There is nothing to complain about. I could say it just works and that would be the end of the video. But there are many new things in Linux Mint 19 which I would like to talk about. The major new thing is a backup tool, TimeShift. And it is the second point why I recommend Linux Mint even stronger than before. Now TimeShift is an essential part of Linux Mint. It backs up your system by creating system snapshots and allows you to go back to the last functional state of your system if some problem happened in your current system. The only lacking feature is to backup over a network. This feature is present in Ubuntu's backup tool, which I covered in my 30 things to do after installing Ubuntu. You can watch it here. I hope the network backup option will be added to the future releases of TimeShift. The implementation of TimeShift also introduced changes to the update manager. This is the third point I like Linux Mint. Its update manager is the best graphical update manager I have ever seen in Linux. It is simple, informative, and it always works. I have seen problems with the update manager in Ubuntu, even in the last 18.04 release. I also constantly have problems updating KDE Neon with the Discover Software Center, which is also the update manager. There are no such issues in Linux Mint. The Linux Mint update manager no longer promotes selective updates. You also won't find the categories of updates, although you can enable them. The Linux Mint update manager installs all available updates and relies on TimeShift to guarantee the stability of your system. If you experience a regression, you can restore the state of your system before the updates. Simple and reliable. You can also configure the update manager to update your system automatically. Again, this is thanks to TimeShift, which gives you the ability to reverse the updates in case of a problem. The security and the kernel updates are at the top now. The Linux Mint team shows they prioritize the security for what they were criticized before. It is nice that Linux Mint listens to its users. The fourth point I like and recommend Linux Mint is the software manager. The Linux Mint software manager was the only software manager which I considered to be usable. It was not nice looking, but it worked 100% of cases I used it. Now, the same stable and reliable software manager has an improved user interface. And this is great. It is very close to a modern looking software manager. I am sure this software manager will attract more new users to Linux Mint. It will be way easier and more pleasant for them to discover the variety of Linux applications. The software manager also supports Flatpak now, which allows you installing applications without the dependency hassle. There are also many under the hood improvements in the software manager, so it also starts faster than before. Little by little, Linux Mint and Linux in general is moving toward nice and functional software manager, which in my view is the first obstacle that may stop some users from switching to Linux. Speaking about user friendliness, I cannot continue without mentioning the welcome screen. This is the fifth point Linux Mint 19 is great. Linux Mint 19 ships with a brand new welcome screen. The new layout makes it easier to guide new users through their first steps in Linux Mint. A new user can configure backups, install drivers, multimedia codecs, configure the update manager, discover system settings, and start installing new programs from the software center. Linux Mint team is also constantly working on improving its documentation. This is rarely mentioned, but if you are a new user, please have a look at Linux Mint documentation. you will find a lot of useful stuff there. Here you can also see the new features in this release and check the release notes for any potential problems, limitations and workarounds. New users are also suggested to visit Linux Mint forum and IRC chat in case they need some help. Finally, you can contribute to Linux Mint project, what I highly encourage you to do. Actually, this help doesn't have to be financial. The sixth point to like Linux Mint is the Cinema desktop. Well, Linux Mint XFCE and Mate are also great. Too bad there is no KDE edition anymore. But Cinema desktop is the default. I cannot say it is the best desktop right now, but it has a very big potential. It is also developed very fast. I remember the first release of Cinema. It was so buggy. But now, Linux Mint 19 ships with the latest Cinema 3.8, which is very stable, and what is especially nice, it is much faster than before. Apps open almost instantly, and it feels faster than GNOME and even Mate. The Linux Mint team specifically work on this speed improvement, and their work is noticeable. The seventh point is Nemo File Manager. Let me be clear, it is not the best file manager. Dolphin File Manager from KDE is the best in my view. But Nemo is the second best file manager I would prefer to use. Nemo is a clean, stable and fast file manager. Actually, Nemo Linux Mint 19 is a little faster at showing directory contents than before. It also no longer lags when moving files over USB devices. Also, what I like about Nemo, it remembers the view option for different folders. For example, I can have an icon view for home folder and list view for downloads. You may be surprised, but many file managers, such as XFCE and GNOME file managers, do not do that. Search in Nemo also works perfectly. It is much faster than before. I would say it is the fastest search in Linux file managers I ever seen. All in all, Nemo is an ideal file manager for new users. It has all the necessary features, and at the same time, it is not as complicated as Dolphin File Manager, which is better suitable for advanced users. The eighth point is look and feel. Linux Mint has a well-familiar layout with a single panel at the bottom. This is appealing to new users who mostly convert from Windows. Linux Mint 19 has a more modern look and it also better supports dark themes. Now Linux Mint uses GTK3, and it should look crisp on high DPI screens. I don't have a high DPI screen, so I cannot test it. If you have tried Linux Mint with a high DPI screen, please let me know how it looks. The ninth point is XApps. XApps are applications specifically designed and developed by Linux Mint team for the Cinema desktop. I like them not because they are the best, but because they provide desktop integrity. In this release of Linux Mint, major improvements have been done to XEdit and XReader. XEdit is a text editor. There is a new preference window, a keyboard shortcuts window was added in the help menu. It now has the word auto-completion plugin and it is able to auto-complete words which are already present in the document. XReader, the PDF reader, also received new preference window and support for optional toolbar buttons. If you enable the option to remember recently accessed files in your privacy settings, XReader displays and provides quick access to your recently opened PDF and EPUB documents. It is now possible to change the size of the thumbnails, and that size is remembered for each document. I hope the Linux Mint team will keep improving its XApps. The last 10th point I would like to emphasize is LTS strategy. Linux Mint supports its distributions for a really long time. Often you can even skip some major LTS releases if you don't want to upgrade. For example, Linux Mint 19 will receive security updates until 2023. So if you install it, you can keep it for the next 5 years. There are many more changes to Linux Mint 19, which will take about an hour to cover them all. In this review, I try to point out the main reasons why I like and recommend Linux Mint 19. What are your reasons to like or dislike Linux Mint? please comment below. And thank you for watching!